Episode of Lamb Like the Animal / Open Microtomy. Today, we're going to be talking about something that's personally been affecting me lately. It's not too serious, but obviously, if you've been paying attention to my channel, you're going to notice I've been gone for a little while. So today, we're going to talk about why that is. Stick around. So, I've been gone a little while. You might be wondering, what happened? Did you stop your channel? Did you stop wanting to do videos? No. Truth is, guys, I suffered for something we're gonna talk about today, and that something is burnout. I got tired of making videos every week, not because it stopped being fun, not because I stopped enjoying it, just because I got tired. I couldn't think of anything. I was emotionally and mentally just drained of ideas. I couldn't think of anything to talk about. So rather than put out bum content, or rather than force myself to I never want to force myself to do something that I enjoy doing because I'm afraid that I'll stop enjoying it. And that's what I want to talk about with burnout today. I think the burnout is going to happen to you regardless of how much you enjoy your hobby, how much you enjoy anything really. But when it comes to a hobby, I think that burnout is a perfect time to sit back, take a little break, and don't push yourself. Obviously, stick with it. I didn't just do nothing. I didn't just take a vacation. I used that time to sit and learn. I got some new camera techniques. I learned a bunch about lighting. I'm not really using it right now, but I used my time off to continue to learn rather than sit around and do nothing. So while I didn't put out videos, I was still participating in my craft. And that's what I want to talk about with burnout. You don't necessarily need to continue doing the same thing over and over in order to overcome your burnout. And sometimes that's not great. And obviously, at certain levels, burnout, you just gotta kind of fight through it. But when it comes to a personal channel like this, or with my comedy, this would happen with my comedy as well, where sometimes I would just have nothing. And rather than being like, oh, I need to get on stage all the time and continue to push, some people might tell you to do that. And, you know, some of those people might be more successful than me, so you know what? Maybe I don't have the best advice. But I think that it is important to take a break and recalculate sometimes. And that is what the point of this burnout was for me. Is it wasn't that I wanted to, I was so tired of doing the same thing over and over. It was, I want to learn how to make things better. And I'm getting tired of doing things the same way. So how am I going to improve? So I took some time off and I learned some new things. I enjoyed, you know, not having to worry about whether or not I was putting out decent content. That was something that was starting to bother me, is what I'm putting out actually worthwhile? So I just wanted to take some time, let people know that burnout is gonna happen. Take your time. I'm gonna keep this video a little bit short for the same reason that I'm talking about before. I need to get back on the horse, and I can't force myself to sit down and edit and shoot this crazy long video just because I've been gone for a while. I'm easing myself back into it the same way that you should ease yourself back into anything that you've taken a break from. Don't go full board. Don't just completely shut off either. Burnout is gonna happen. Don't worry about it, whether this is comedy related or not. And I'll go into comedy a little bit with that. As I said before, when I would do comedy, sometimes I just wouldn't feel like doing comedy. So rather than push myself to go on stage and make myself do something that I wanted to do, and I know that sounds weird, make myself do something that I want to do. Like, you should just, if I just want to do it, I should want to do it. You don't always want to do everything all the time. And this is something that I do take somewhat seriously, or at least more seriously than my other hobbies. I consider this still a hobby right now because I'm not making any money, but realistically, this is what I want to do. Videos, comedy, it's all. This is, my art is what I value. And I don't want to burn myself out by doing it over and over and making myself hate the thing that I want to be good at, the thing that I really do enjoy. If I force myself to hate it, then what's the point of it? So with comedy, if I got tired of telling jokes, I would sit down and I'd write jokes instead. or I would watch people tell jokes. I wouldn't make myself do anything that felt uncomfortable. And obviously, sometimes you have to push yourself in certain directions to be uncomfortable. But when you're just tired, and you really can't go any further, and you're just spinning the wheels, stop spinning those wheels, maybe put it in reverse and find a different path. But you need to keep going forward. It's okay to have little breaks. It's okay to just chill. Don't let burnout affect you. It's not affecting me. I'm happy to be back. This is the first time I've sat in front of a camera and I'm so excited. I played with my new camera. I played with my new coffee machine thingy. It's not a coffee machine. It's a pour over coffee maker. But I was excited to play with my camera today. And for a while there, I wasn't really getting excited. It was becoming a chore. And I never want what I enjoy doing to become a chore. So if you're feeling bummed out by burnout, don't worry about it. So thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. I know this wasn't very informative, but I wanted to sort of do a return to form video and also talk about burnout a little bit. It happens. Don't freak out about it. I'm going to be trying to drop videos more reliably than I have for the past month or so. Obviously, holidays and stuff, everything just kind of came to a T. So took my little bit of a break. Hope you didn't miss me too much. Thanks for watching. I'm out with Open Mic Academy / Lamb Like Deer.